The only way to solve the mysteries of our universe is to further back in time and see how everything came to be. Of course, that is easier said than done. However, the James Webb Telescope is set to go further back in time than its predecessor, the Hubble. So how will it do that? Let's find out. The capability to look back in time depends on the fact that even light has a specific speed limit. For example, the light goes at 186,000 miles per second. What that means is that even the natural sunlight that comes to us has left the sun over 8 minutes ago. However, the larger distance you observe in the universe, the more time has passed since the light you observe has set off on its way towards you. That is why when you look at something in space that is 30 light years away, what it means is that it looked like this 30 years ago. So the same applies to anything millions of light years away. The MIRI in the James Webb Telescope will enable astronomers to look at everything inside our universe in great detail, such as atmospheres of exoplanets for signs of life. In addition, the MIRI can look much deeper than Hubble into the mid-infrared, which means we can see what happened further away and a long time ago. The most interesting thing about JWST is that all its instruments will begin by observing infrared light. An advantage of this is that infrared can pass through any interstellar dust that hinders visible light. As a result, the visible light that travels from a faraway star is also stretched on its journey to us. In simple terms, the wavelength becomes longer, which means that the light that was in our visible spectrum has shifted down into the infrared. That is known as redshift. And it means that if you want to look further back in time, you will have to look at things not visible in our spectrum. The JWST will be able to detect these invisible objects through its three detectors that are tuned into the near-infrared. As the name suggests, that is beyond the reds we can see with our naked eye. Because of this, the astronomers hope that we can look back to almost the beginning of the universe. Of course, we don't know much about this era or what happened, which is why the JWST will offer us a deep insight into these things. The Hubble showed us what the galaxies look like now, or even in later periods. However, what it does not show us is how the first stars and galaxies formed. The JWST, through all its instruments and mirrors, will go back in time and give us more information about the era that the Hubble can't tell us about. That is why the excitement is real, and we can't wait for the telescope to send over its first images to us. It will finally help us answer many questions that have puzzled us for a long time to come. The mission plans to last less than 6 years, and the first images will come in a few months. So get ready for some answers to many questions about our world.